2001, I was amazed, awed, to say the least. The entire scope of the movie was overpowering, and for most of the people of the world, was completely baffling. Most people who saw that movie did not understand from beginning to end what it was that they had experienced, but they knew, everyone who saw it, knew that they had experienced something profound. That something had been communicated to the dark, deep recesses of their mind, which they did not understand. And indeed, which they were incapable of understanding. For you see, the movie was not meant for the profane, as most of us are called, by the adepts or the initiates or the priests of the mystery schools. For that movie was a message to those initiates who were well versed in the symbology and the mystery religion, of an ancient religion that is practiced to this day in secret. Now I'm going to tell you the meaning of the symbology that you saw in the movie 2001, and then each and every listener should go to their local video rental store and watch the movie again from beginning to end, for it is the story of the entire human race according to the history of the mystery religion of ancient Babylon. Now I can assure you that you will not understand any of what you are going to hear without ample preparation and without a basic understanding in the symbology of the ancient religion. And you're going to get that, and this is going to be a series of programs that will, in fact, take probably many hours to complete. But let me just go over the symbology of the movie 2001 quickly with you, and then we will go back to the very beginning, to the first primitive human, probably sitting on his haunches, munching upon some vegetable, watching the sunrise in the east. In the beginning of the movie 2001, most people who sat in the theater were struck by the imagery which was presented to them, as they saw first a dark and gray and ugly world. And as that world began to move down from the center of the screen, they saw behind it a moon. And as the moon began to come down with the world that was sinking to the lower part of the screen, behind it you saw the emergence of the sun. What you were witnessing was an eclipse of the sun, partial eclipse, and as the light from the sun spilled across the edge of the moon, it took the shape of the boat of Isis. And the sun, of course, for anyone who has studied the Osirian cycle, became Osiris. And the symbology was Osiris riding across the heavens upon the boat of Isis. Now, this will all have much deeper meaning to you as we progress toward your education in the ancient mystery schools, which are today known by many different names, and we will get to some of those names as we go along. This signified, of course, the creation of the universe and of the world. And what we saw next was a barren plain, nothing growing, barren rocks, barren desert. And then we saw the sun begin to rise in the east over the horizon, signifying the birth of the world. As the sun traveled across the heavens, you saw the wind begin to move across the face of the earth, signifying that something was happening. Then as the sun began to reach its zenith on a prime longitude, we began to see shrubs, small green plants began to emerge. Now the sun traveling across the heavens did not, of course, signify a day. It signified an age, dear listeners. As the sun sank deeper into the afternoon, we saw the emergence of animal life, birds. And we could hear the birds singing, and we could see the animals. And then we could see primitive man in the form of an ape mingling amongst the animals, neither harming the other, living in a state of innocence. And you saw man only eating plants and roots. And you saw that even when the animals and man were in competition for food, no one was injured or hurt, but there was a display of waving of arms and yelling and grunting until one or the other moved away. The significance of this was the age of innocence, when man lived in the Garden of Eden, innocent, with the animals. It was a vegetarian. And as the sun progressed farther toward the west, we saw man begin to retreat into the womb. For you see, the passage of the sun across the sky from the time that it rose in the east, signifying the birth of the world, we saw that as it reached its zenith, its most powerful aspect in the heavens, life began to emerge first in the form of plants and then animal life. And that the animals and early man lived in harmony together in a state of innocence. This was the symbology of the movie.